Okay, Shalom to the elect of the nation of Israel, which begins with the 144,000. All praises and glories due to the Heavenly Father Yahweh, Baal Shem Yahushai, Baal Shem Rakakwadash. And this will be another video. I'm going to call it These IUIC Guys Are Delusional. These IUIC Guys Are Delusional. Now, what inspired me to do this video was I was watching this video here by, the brother from England, Elder Yawakanan. Okay, and this is his channel here, Hebrew Israelite Yawakanan 144. The title of this video is Pastors Sit Down with IUIC Detroit, who claim to keep all the commandments. So without further ado, let's listen to some of this video.
The commandments cannot save you. Brothers and sisters, please listen carefully. I did a lesson on this on Saturday on the Highways and Edges, right? If you go to my channel, did a lesson. It's called Faith in Righteousness. And I explained to you clearly that the laws, commandments, and statutes cannot save you. Just like what this preacher said here, right? He said, what is the purpose of Yahweh Shai? If that was the case, well, listen to what they say. Go back. Listen to what he says. Listen to what the preacher says to them.
I'm saying you always have to keep the commandments. Only the way to get saved is by keeping the commandments.
Okay.
But what I'm saying is,
so what's the point of Christ then?
That's what I'm answering.
So
because of Christ. The point of Christ is to save you. Watch this. Read Hebrews 9:15.
Because if you look at the why you getting that, if you look at the history of Israel, they were never able to keep the commandments. They were never able to keep.
They are you.
So you
they your ancestors.
So you keep all
your ancestors.
You keep all every single one.
Yeah, just not the law side.
You keep every single one.
Yeah, we just finished celebrating the Feast of Dedication.
What's that?
He's not understanding the question, the IUIC guy. Okay, the dude with the hat, he just asked you, do you keep all, does he realize, does the IUIC guy realize there's over 613 laws? All right, minus the sacrificial law. We don't do that anymore because Yahushua did away with it. But there's still many laws that we certainly cannot keep in this captivity, okay, in this slavery, all right, underneath Esau. Okay, so how is it possible for him to keep every law, statute, and commandments? He's delusional, okay? He has a zeal, but not according to knowledge. Okay, let's hear that again.
You keep all every single one.
Yeah, just not the law, sir.
He said, the guy asked him, you keep every single one? He said, yeah, not, yeah. Just not the law, the sacrificial, the law of the sacrifice. Let's say that one more time.
They were never able to keep.
They are you.
So you
they your ancestors.
So you keep all every single one.
Yeah, just not the law, sir.
You keep every single one.
Yeah, we just finished celebrating the Feast of Dedication.
What's that?
Now, you know what? The guy with the hat, he made a good point. Okay, because let me bring it back. He said, historically, the nation of Israel were never able to keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. See, what the IUIC guy don't realize is for you to be justified by the law, because he said the only thing that can save you is the laws, statutes, and commandments. For you to be justified by the laws, statutes, and commandments, you got to keep every one of them. Okay, let me show you that scripture. This is why the scriptures speak about these guys desiring to be teachers of the law. They don't understand what, matter of fact, I'll get that next. All right. This is because the church at Galatia, also known as the Galatians, that was their stumbling block too. Okay. They thought that salvation could be had by keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. And the Apostle Paul checked them. He said, look, you guys, you began in the spirit, and now you think you can be made perfect by the flesh? And when the Apostle Paul said perfect by the flesh, he means you think you can receive salvation by keeping all the laws, statutes, and commandments, which it's impossible for you to do. Even back then, they couldn't do it. Anyway, Galatians, the fifth chapter, and the third verse, it says, for I testify again to every man that is circumcised, that he is a debtor, because they back then they used to boast about being circumcised, which is goes back to the law. right? Just because you're circumcised doesn't mean that you're part of the Lord's elect, okay? It says, for I testify again to every man that is circumcised that he is a debtor to do the whole law. He's a debtor to do the whole law, okay? Which you simply cannot do, okay? Now, let's go to 1 Timothy 1 and 7 because that's, you know, that's the thing with this IUIC group. They desire to be teachers of the law, but they don't understand what the hell they're talking about. Okay, this is the book of 1 Timothy. 1 Timothy 1 and 6. For which some, having swerved from what? From the truth, having turned aside unto vain jangling. When he made that statement, I keep all the law, statutes, and commandments, just not the law of sacrifice. That's vain jangling, man. Vain jangling, okay? You don't know what you're talking about. Here's the next verse. Desiring to be teachers of the law, understanding neither what they say, nor whereof they affirm. The guy blatantly sat there and said he keeps all the law, statutes, and commandments. Something the Israelites could not do more than 2,000 years ago, okay? Which is why ultimately we went into captivity. So based upon what he just said, the IUIC guy, then he doesn't need a savior. He doesn't need to be changed. He doesn't need a savior because he can keep all the law, statutes, and commandments. Those guys are totally delusional. They don't know what the hell they're talking about. Let's read that in the NLT. 1 Timothy 1 and 7. It says, they want to be known as teachers of the law of Moses, but they don't know what they are talking about, even though they speak so confidently. Let's get back to the video.
Look
at how he's sitting. You know, he's sitting. He's got his two hands together. They call it steepling, right? Like he's so in control. Like he really knows what he's talking about. He doesn't know what he's talking about. All right?
They were able to keep the commandments. They were never able to keep
wheat.
And that's a good point. And that's why, I think the guy with the hat, what he just said today, I think I'm trying to remember that scripture, how it's worded so I can find it for you. Let me see if I type in, they could not keep the law of Moses. That's why they have to be a new covenant. They could not keep scripture, man. KJV. Oh boy. That's pretty good. John 7:19. Did not Moses give you the law, and yet none of you keepeth the law? Give me for a minute. Let me type in the stony heart. Probably not going to be able to find that scripture. I can't. And they made their hearts as adamant. At least they hear the Lord. And this is why, as a matter of fact, you know what? Let's go to Ezekiel 36. This is why there had to be a new covenant. And we're going to go from hearts of stone, which The law was written on tables of stone, which represented our hearts. We had them stony hearts, so we couldn't keep the law perfectly to be justified by the law. That's why when you go to Ezekiel, the 36th chapter, it says the Heavenly Father got to make a new covenant with us. Now, that new covenant kicks in right after we're delivered by Yahweh Shai, because our bodies are going to be changed. Then the laws are going to be put in our inward parts. Then we can boast and say we can keep all the laws. So that guy from the IUIC, he don't know what he's talking about. Ezekiel 36 and Ezekiel 36 and 23, and I will sanctify my great name, which was profaned among the heathen. We're approaching that time now. What's going to help to do that is the destruction, the you know, World War III and the chariots of the Lord. What it will serve to do is magnify the Heavenly Father's name and at the same time sanctify it. His name is Yahweh, his son's name is Yahweh Shai, which ye have profaned in the midst of them, and the heathen shall know that I am the Lord. Yeah, especially when they see the destruction that the Heavenly Father is going to bring through his son, Yahweh Shai, you know. Saith the Lord, power, when I shall be sanctified in you before their eyes. Absolutely, beginning with the elect. You know, beginning with the elect of the nation of Israel, when the destruction comes, the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, through his son, Yahweh Shai, will be sanctified through us. Okay? Reading on, it says, for I will take you from among the heathen, which is what Yahweh Shai is going to do, right? And gather you out of all the countries and will bring you into your own land. This links up with Isaiah 14 and 1. For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel and bring them back to their own land, beginning with the elect, right? Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you. Why is that? Because remember in 1 Corinthians 15 chapter, it says, we shall be changed in the twinkling of an eye. So this guy from the IUIC is sitting there talking about he can keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. I guess he doesn't need to be changed. He doesn't need a savior, and he doesn't need to be changed. They don't know what they're talking about, okay? Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean, right? After we're delivered, right, by Yahweh Shai, and once we enter those chariots, 1 Corinthians 15 tells us our bodies are going to be changed. We're going to go from being in the corruptible to the incorruptible, okay? Another thing, too, with the IUIC guy, he's saying he can keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. That means he's not in the corruptible. Essentially, that's what he's saying. He's saying he's incorruptible, which is the furthest thing from the truth. He just doesn't know what he's talking about, okay? It says, then, well, that's why the Apostle Paul told Timothy they desire to be teachers of the law, but they don't understand what they're saying nor what they affirm, okay? And then he's sitting there with his two hands together, in a posture called steepling, you can look it up, and talking as if he know what he's talking about, okay? Tell you, man, Jake is something else. Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you, and ye shall be clean, right? After we're delivered by Yahweh Shai, and our bodies are changed, and then we're brought back to the you know, the land of Israel, we're going to be made perfect, okay? We're going to be perfect. Then we're going to keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. Because we're going to be programmed to. Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean. From all your filthiness and from all your idols will I cleanse you. A new heart also will I give you, see? And a new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh. That's why the law was written on tables of stone, which represented our hearts. There's no one that can keep all the law, statutes, and commandments. The only one that was able to do it was Yahweh Shai, and he's not even on the planet Earth. He's in the heavens. Okay, and he's been made perfect. All right, so I don't know what the hell that IUIC guy is talking about. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And this is why we tell you GMS has 100% truth. This is just another example. Guy sitting there talking about he can keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. Talk about the delusion, man. Well, there's a scripture where the Lord said, I will choose their delusions. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh. See, that's when our stony hearts are going to be taken out. And, you know, it's a metaphor, stony heart. And we're going to be given a heart of flesh, which is also a metaphor. Meaning we're going to be given a mind that's able to keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. That's what that means, okay? I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh, and I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes. and ye shall keep my judgments and do them, and ye shall dwell in the land that I gave to your fathers. Has this happened yet? Oh, hell no. This is going to happen when Yahushua comes, pursuant to Isaiah 14 and 1, and delivers us and brings us back to Israel, beginning with the elect. So what is that IUIC guy talking about? He can keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. Yeah, sure you can. And ye shall dwell in the land that I gave to your fathers, and ye shall be my people, and I will be your power. See? I will also save you from all your uncleanliness, and I will call for the corn and will increase it. Right, we're going to be underneath the blessings. Deuteronomy 28 chapter, begin at the first verse to the 15th verse, or to the 14th verse. Okay, we're going to enjoy all the blessings, right? Excuse me. It says, I will also save you from all your uncleanliness, and I will call for the corn and will increase it and lay no famine upon you. And I will multiply the fruit of the tree and the increase. We're going to be under the blessings. And the increase of the field, and ye shall receive no more reproach of famine among the heathen, no more curses. Then shall ye remember your own evil ways and your doings that were not good, and shall loathe yourselves in your own sight for your iniquities and for your abominations. What? Yeah, the wickedness that we did on this side. We're going to remember that in the kingdom, and we're going to, it's going to humble us. Okay? So you get the picture. All right? So that's when we're going to be changed. That's when we're going to be able to boast and say we can keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. Okay? Let's move on.
You keep every single one, just not the law of sacrifice.
This guy doesn't know what he's talking about.
We just finished celebrating the feast of dedication.
What's that? Did you answer to him? Does he keep every single commandment?
For goodness sakes, the IUIC, they don't even know when the Sabbath comes in, man. They can't even do that right. Keep the Sabbath. The Sabbath is regulated by the new moon. They can't even do that right. They still believe that Friday night sundown, the Saturday night sundown is the Sabbath. Now, the only way it can be the Sabbath is if it falls on the new moon. But if it doesn't fall on the new moon, it's not the Sabbath. They're still following the so-called Jew. The so-called Jew, the small hatters, they're the ones that keep the Sabbath, Friday night sundown, the Saturday night sundown. Okay?
He had the audacity, the IUIC member, to say yes.
Yep.
That's a complete lie, because none of us can keep.
No, you know what it is, brother? Let me bring that scripture back. Now we understand why the Apostle Paul said that to Timothy. Because Timothy encountered those clowns back then. Okay? And the Apostle Paul encountered those clowns back then. All right? First Timothy, and I lay that blame on the doorstep of Bishop Nathaniel, because that's the nonsense that he teaches. He doesn't see in their ministry, they don't put the look in the book of Hebrews. It says we look unto Yahushua, the author and finisher of our faith. Yahushua is the center attraction here, not the law, statutes, and commandments. The spirit of Yahushua brought us into this knowledge, this truth, not the law, statutes, and commandments. That's the same argument the Apostle Paul had with the Galatians. Okay? Anyway, 1 Timothy 1 and 6, it says, from which some having swerved have turned aside unto vain jangling. That's what you're witnessing. That IUIC guy, the nonsense that he's saying is vain jangling. Okay? Talking about he can keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments, just not the law of sacrifice. Come on, dude. It says, desiring to be teachers of the law. That's them. Understanding neither what they say, no way of they affirm. That's the perfect scripture for that scenario.
Can keep all of the commandments. None of us can. That's he had right. The audacity to actually say, yes, he keeps all of the commandments.
And even if he were to keep all the commandments, which it's impossible for him to do, but even if he was to do it, well, what does Isaiah say? Let's go to Isaiah 64, which is a cold cut, man. You're still looked at as a filthy rag, man. You're sitting there at steepling, feeling yourself, looking all proud. You don't know what the hell you're talking about. Isaiah 64 and 6. Isaiah 64 and 6. Let's read that. It says, but we are all as an unclean thing. Now, when are we going to be cleansed? Well, I read it to you in Ezekiel. When Yahushua comes and he delivers us from the destruction, and then we're changed. Remember, our bodies have to be changed Remember what it says in 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. The corruptible must put on incorruption. When that happens, that's when we're going to be cleansed. That's when we're going to be clean in the sight of Yahweh Bar Shem Yahushai. Till then, we're still, and we're, this is why the Apostle Paul made the statement, who shall deliver me from this body of death? Now, keep in mind, when the Apostle Paul, before he became Apostle Paul, he was Saul as a Pharisee. He kept the law, statutes, and commandments. Okay, he called himself a Pharisee of the Pharisees. All right, he was super diligent concerning the law. Okay, so not even the Apostle Paul would make a stupid statement like that. Okay, anyway, Isaiah 64 and 6, it says, but we are all as an unclean thing. See, so even if you were able to keep all the law, statutes, and commandments, you would still be looked at as an unclean thing. Okay, because we haven't been cleansed yet. All right, we're in the beginning stages of it. There's a scripture in Psalm 119 and 9, it says, how does a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed thereunto according to thy word. So we're in the beginning stages of it, but we haven't been cleansed yet. We're not cleansed until Yahweh Shai delivers us. And then in the chariots we change. And then when we're brought back to Israel, that, like the Lord said, we fall underneath the new covenant, Ezekiel, the 36th chapter. Okay? Then we're going to enjoy the blessings and all of that, enjoy the kingdom and all of that. So it says, but we are all as an unclean thing, and all our righteousness. So this guy's sitting there steepling, right? Feeling himself with his righteousness. Yeah, keep all the laws. Yeah, just not the law of sacrifice. Well, the Bible says, and all our righteousness are as filthy rags. Now what, dude? And we all do fade as a leaf. You're going to tell me, first of all, if that guy was able to keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments, he'd never die. He'd never die. He wouldn't get sick, okay? He wouldn't get old, okay? He wouldn't so much as have a headache or a toothache, okay? He would be perfect. So you're going to tell me that IUIC guy sitting there is perfect? See, this is the delusions that these guys are under, man, okay? But we are all as an unclean thing, and all our righteousness are as filthy rags, and we do all fade as a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, have taken us away. Right. And you're going to tell me he doesn't sin? If the Bible even said that a foolish thought, listen good, a foolish thought is sin. So you're going to tell me the guy sitting there, the IUIC guy, he doesn't have foolish thoughts? He doesn't have wicked thoughts? He doesn't have carnal thoughts? Come on, man. Let's get back to the video.
Comments. Nobody can keep all the commandments, because if would be no point for Yahweh Shai. He is our mediator for when we go.
And that's right. That's Elder Yahweh Khan speaking. And that's the thing. See, that group, they omit Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai is not the center attraction of their ministry. No, the center attraction of the IUIC's ministry is the law, statutes, and commandments. They talk more about the law, statutes, and commandments than they do Yahweh Shai. All right. First of all, they don't even call the man by his name. They call him Christ. See? So let's move on, man.
All right. So that's a complete false statement that he made there.
Absolutely.
Right? I don't know the brother.
It's an unlearned statement. It's an unlearned statement. That like the Apostle Paul said, they have a zeal, but not according to knowledge. Let's get that. Let's get that. Romans, what is that? Romans 10. Romans 10. Romans 10. And see, that was the whole argument that the Apostle Paul had with the Israelite foreigners and the Jews. It was about that law. Okay, they really felt that salvation could be had by the law. They forget one thing. For you to be justified by the law, you have to keep all the laws. And you simply cannot do that. It's impossible. Okay? Romans 10, chapter, the first verse. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to the Most High for Israel is that they might be saved. But the truth is, only the elect are going to be saved. And the elect are going to trust in Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Bar Shem Yahweh Shai. Not in the law. The elect is going to trust in Yahweh Shai for their salvation. Okay? Which Yahweh Shai is a walking embodiment of the law anyway. It says, brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to the Most High for Israel is that they might be saved. For I bear them record, and so do we, that they have a zeal, of the Heavenly Father. See, they have a zeal. He has a zeal. He's sitting there, you know, he's proud, he's steepling his hands, and he's talking about how he keeps the laws. We just celebrated this and all that. They have a zeal, but not according to knowledge. See, that's the point. Not according to knowledge. For they being ignorant of the Heavenly Father's righteousness. And where does the Heavenly Father's righteousness begin? It begins with Yahweh Shai, accepting Yahweh Shai, believing in Yahweh Shai, worshiping Yahweh Shai. That's where it starts. Okay? It says, for they being ignorant of the Most High's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness. Oh, yeah, I keep all the commandments. Yeah, the only commandment I don't keep is the law of sacrifice. Yeah, we just celebrated such and such. Come on, man. And going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of the Heavenly Father. And who is that? That's Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai is the righteousness of the Heavenly Father. You submit unto him. All right? You worship him. See? But they omit Yahweh Shai in their practice. Uh-huh. For goodness sakes, they don't even call the man by his name. They call him Christ. What more do you need? What more proof do you need?
But I know there's no one on planet Earth that can keep all the commandments. The only person that did it was Yahweh Shai.
That's right. That's right.
The only person that never broke a commandment was Yahweh Shai. So for him to...
Notice he says Yahweh Shai, not Christ.
Say that, he's completely going off. That's off.
Yeah, because he doesn't understand. He's sitting there like he's an expert, but in reality, he's a novice. Lifted up with, he seems to be a little proud too. Well, them IUIC guys, a lot of them are proud. They're foolishly proud, okay? It is what it is.
Full statement that he's made. I'll give you one, it's going to go back to it. Because he asks him clearly, he says, you keep all the commandments? He says, yeah, I keep all the commandments. Is it? Okay. I'll give you one scripture. We're going to go back to this. I want to give you one scripture, the book of James, just to make you understand, right? When I say that, keeping the commandments can't save you, but do we tell you to keep them? Yes, to the best of your ability. We always ask you to do that.
Yeah, there's a scripture where it says we live by the commandments. Certain commandments, like when the Lord tells us not to eat pork. That's a common sense law right there. You know, when you don't eat pork in your diet, man, you avert a lot of diseases. A lot of diseases come from pork. So when the Lord told us to stay away from pork, right? That's a common sense law. The law is common sense. But there are laws that the Heavenly Father has on the books that we simply cannot keep. Why? Because we're in this captivity. We're in this slavery. That's why we have to be delivered first and then changed. You see, there's a step to be able to say, I can keep all the commandments, laws, statutes, and commandments. There are steps to be taken. Okay? And we're in the initial steps. We're getting this knowledge, this truth, which is going to lead us to salvation, which is going to lead us to perfection by Yahweh Shai, all done by Yahweh Shai, not by the law. The law ain't going to deliver us. The law is not going to change us. It's Yahweh Shai that's going to deliver us and change us. Okay? What don't they get about that? Well, they worship Christ anyway, so they're way off.
James 2, just quickly go to straight to the point. Now, this is the point. This is what this brother claims. It says, for whosoever shall keep the whole law, and yet offending one point, he is guilty of all. Why? Yeah. Because the Lord knows no one can keep all the commandments. That's why he's there. He's our grace. He's our mediator.
That's right.
So for him to claim that he can keep...
But he doesn't need a mediator. 1 Timothy 2:5 speaks about the mediator, which is Yahweh Shai. But that IUIC guy, he doesn't need a mediator because he can keep all the laws, statutes, and commandments. You just heard what he said, right? These guys are totally delusional. I hope he can save him. If he keeps on with that attitude, I hope he can save himself when that destruction comes, because he doesn't need a savior.
If he offends in one point, he's guilty in them all.
That's it.
So he's made a complete full statement there. He's lied to that preacher by telling that he keeps all the commandments. Completely lied to him.
You don't know. He just don't know what he's talking about. He just don't know what he's talking about. Like the Apostle Paul told Timothy, desiring to be teachers of the Lord, they don't understand what they say, nor where they affirm, nor whereof they affirm. He doesn't know what he's talking about.
He's absolutely lied to that pastor by making that statement.
Absolutely. Yeah, so I'm going to end it there. Hopefully you were edified. Go check this video out. I'm about to watch the whole thing. All right. Elder Yawakonnan from the UK. You can no doubt tell by his accent. The name of the video is Pastor Sit Down with IUIC Detroit. So I hope this guy, the IUIC guy, I hope he sees this video and reconsider what he's saying, because you're being led the wrong way, my man. All right. And if you don't repent from that delusional spirit you're in, you're going to be destroyed, man. All right. Yahweh Shai is the focal point. Yahweh Shai is the pastor asked him, well, what's the purpose of Christ then? He said Christ, but his true name is Yahweh Shai. He said, the attitude that you got, IUIC guy, saying you can keep all the laws, statutes, commandments, then what's the purpose of our Lord dying on the cross then? What was that all about? And then he made some half-hearted statement concerning Christ, which is his true name is Yahweh Shai. And then he went right back to how they keep the law, how he doesn't, because the pastor asked him, well, do you keep all the laws? He said, yeah, just not the law of sacrifice. Come on, man. Anyway, on to the next one.